a gay rugby player who is facing deportation to Kenya, where he fears he will be subjected to persecution and violence because of his sexuality, has had a fresh claim for asylum rejected. The 39-year-old, who plays for Bristol Bisons, a gay and inclusive rugby club, says he is feeling depressed at the decision, which came as a big surprise, adding, "I am feeling hopeless at the moment." A Home Office decision letter sent to Macharia's solicitor acknowledged that gay sex in Kenya is punishable by up to 21 years in prison and that LGBT people have reportedly been subjected to harassment, blackmail, and rape. However, the letter added, while same-sexual activity between men has been criminalized with a penalty of up to 21 years in prison, this law is rarely applied and the objective evidence does not establish that LGBT persons are likely to be subjected to persecution or serious harm. The Home Office's decision comes days after Kenya's High Court last month upheld laws that criminalize gay sex in what was described by a campaigner as a sad day for the rule of law and human rights. Macharia, who first claimed asylum in May 2016, arrived in the UK on a student visa in 2009. Macharia, a mechanical design engineer, has twice been granted extensions of his leave to remain as a student and then as a highly skilled migrant. At and proud LGBT celebrities, provided by photo services. Popular by her stage name Superwoman, the Indian origin Canadian artiste posted a tweet in February 2019, revealing that she is bisexual. She wrote, "Throughout my life these have proven to be obstacles from time to time, but now I'm fully embracing them as my superpowers." The Twitterati came out in support, liking and sharing her tweet in thousands. She responded with another tweet saying, "Thank you so much for the love and positivity. Words can't describe how much it means. I appreciate you all. Group hug, heart, 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 heart." Jolie, who dated actress model Jenny Shimizu in the 90s, spoke about her bisexuality in a 2001 interview to Movie Line and said, "When I was 20, I fell in love with somebody who happened to be a woman. I didn't flirt around with girls. I just suddenly noticed this woman's sweater and the way her pants fit and realized, my God, I was noticing things in a sexual way. I wanted to be close to her because I had feelings for her. The reality is, I love people." While talking about the inspiration behind her single, Girls, the pop star tweeted in 2018 saying, "Girls was written to represent my truth and is an accurate account of a very real and honest experience in my life. I have had a romantic relationship with women and men throughout my life and this is my personal journey." Heard, ex-wife of actor Johnny Depp, revealed she was bisexual in a 2010 interview, reported by People. The actress said she has never hidden her sexuality, however, her disclosure impacted her career. "It was difficult. I was the only one working in this way, so it was difficult because no one had done it. I did that even though everyone told me it would end my career. Without a doubt." In May 2012, a New York Times article confirmed Parsons was gay and in a long-term relationship. The Big Bang Theory actor spoke about his personal life when accepting GLSEN Respect Awards, the Inspiration Award, the following year. He said, "I've never considered my relationship with Todd Spiewak to be an act of activism. Rather simply, it's an act of love, coffee in the morning, going to work, washing the clothes, taking the dogs out, a regular life, boring love." He married Spiewak in 2017. Fox opened up about being bisexual in a 2009 interview to Esquire magazine and stated, "I think people are born bisexual and then make subconscious choices based on the pressures of society. I have no question in my mind about being bisexual." In 2007, the Silence of the Lambs actress appeared to confirm her same-sex relationship when she thanked then-partner Sydney Bernard. A more formal declaration was made in 2013, when she received the Cecil B. DeMille Award at the Golden Globes. She said, "So while I'm here being all confessional, I guess I have a sudden urge to say something that I've never really been able to air in public. I already did my coming out about 1,000 years ago back in the Stone Age, in those very quaint days when a fragile young girl would open up to trusted friends and family and co-workers and then gradually, proudly to everyone who knew her, to everyone she actually met. The award-winning English actor revealed he was gay during a program on BBC Radio 3. The show was discussing a then controversial section of the local government bill 1988. The legislation prevented local authorities from intentionally promoting homosexuality or publishing material with the intention of promoting homosexuality. 10 years later, during an interview about the Stonewall riots in New York, U.S. in 1969, McKellen said, "I have many regrets about not having come out earlier, but one of them might be that I didn't engage myself in the politicking." The Panic at the Disco vocalist came out as pansexual in an interview with a paper magazine. He said, "I'm married to a woman and I'm very much in love with her, but I'm not opposed to a man because to me, I like a person. Yeah, I guess you could qualify me as pansexual because I really don't care. If a person is great, then a person is great. I just like good people. If your heart's in the right place. I'm definitely attracted to men. It's just people that I am attracted to." The Twilight star has repeatedly spoken about her sexuality post her breakup with co-star Robert Pattinson. After coming out during Saturday Night Live episode in February 2017, Stewart told The Guardian in a March interview that she doesn't understand why bisexuals are labeled as confused. "It's not confusing at all. For me, it's quite the opposite," she said. "I'm just trying to acknowledge that fluidity, that grayness, which has always existed. But maybe only now are we allowed to start talking about it." In a 2013 interview to 17 magazine, the pop star spoke about her sexual orientation and said that she is attracted to both men and women. "I don't love just men. I love people. It's not about a gender. It's just about the spirit that exudes from that other person you're with," she said. The Latin pop singer posted about his orientation on his official website in March 2010. He stated, "I am proud to say that I am a fortunate homosexual man. I am very blessed to be who I am. These years in silence and reflection made me stronger and reminded me that acceptance has to come from within, and that this kind of truth gives me the power to conquer emotions I didn't even know existed." In 2010, the True Blood star announced her bisexuality in a PSA video promoting the Give a Damn campaign, saying, "I'm Anna Paquin. I'm bisexual and I give a d**." The Oscar and Grammy award-winning singer-songwriter came out in 2014, when he released his debut album, In the Lonely Hour. At the time, he said the album was about a guy that I fell in love with last year, and he didn't love back. It's about a guy and that's what I wanted people to know. I want to be clear that that's what it's about. People wouldn't ask a straight person these questions. In an April 2018 interview with Rolling Stone magazine, the actor-singer admitted she initially identified herself as a bisexual, but later with pansexuality. She said, "Later I read about pansexuality and was like, oh, these are things that I identify with too. I'm open to learning more about who I am." Thorne, who played Cece Jones in the Disney sitcom Shake It Up, confirmed her bisexuality on Twitter in 2016. She posted an intimate photo of herself with another woman, to which a fan asked, "Are you bisexual?" Thorne's reply, "Yes." Barrymore admitted she was bisexual in a 2003 interview with Contact Music, saying, "I love a woman's body. I think a woman and a woman together are beautiful, just as a man and a woman together are beautiful. Being with a woman is like exploring your own body, but through someone else." The Juno and Inception star came out on Valentine's Day in 2014 at the Human Rights Campaign's Time to Thrive conference. Speaking at the event, she said, "I'm here today because I am gay, and because maybe I can make a difference to help others have an easier and more hopeful time. Regardless, for me, I feel a personal obligation and a social responsibility. Page added, I am tired of hiding and I am tired of lying by omission. I suffered for years because I was scared to be out. My spirit suffered, my mental health suffered, and my relationships suffered. And I'm standing here today, with all of you, on the other side of all that pain. The popular daytime talk show host and comedian announced her sexuality in style by featuring on the cover of Time magazine's April 1997 issue with the headline, Yep, I'm gay, speaking about the cover later. She said, I never wanted to be the lesbian actress, I never wanted to be the spokesperson for the gay community. Ever. I did it for my own truth. The a la McBeal and Arrested Development star acknowledged her sexual orientation in 2005 in interviews with Details and the Advocate magazines. A more public acknowledgement came in 2013, when she accompanied partner Ellen DeGeneres to the Golden Globes red carpet, of which she said, Ellen DeGeneres and I had been together for a month, and I was very, very nervous going to that Golden Globe Awards because I knew that I was going to meet up with her after the show and that there was press. That was the first time that we actually stepped out together as a couple, but for me, it was the first time that I'd stepped out as a gay woman, really. Best known for her role as Miranda Hobbs in the Sex and the City franchise, Nixon disclosed her sexuality in 2012, calling her orientation a choice, speaking to the New York Times later that year. She said, while I don't often use the word, the technically precise term for my orientation is bisexual. I believe bisexuality is not a choice, it is a fact. What I have chosen is to be in a gay relationship. In 2018, the actress turned politician. She identified herself as queer. In a 2014 interview with Diane Sawyer, and the last one given as the gender transition, the former Olympic gold medalist said she wanted to be recognized as a woman. The following year, she was featured on the cover of Vanity Fair magazine with the headline, Call Me Caitlin. She then tweeted, I'm so happy after such a long struggle to be living my own true self. Welcome to the world, Caitlin. Can't wait for you to get to know her, me. The Australian actress, model and musician was 12 years old when she came out to her mother. In an interview with Willy Geist on Sunday Today in February 2017, she admitted she was unsure of how to describe her feelings. She said, I was just worried because I didn't know it was a thing. I knew how I felt, I knew what I kind of identified as, but the words gay or lesbian. I didn't know anyone else that was gay or lesbian, so I didn't really know how to word it. I was just like, I think I should let you know that when I eventually get a boyfriend, it will be girl. Although John said he was bisexual in a 1976 interview with Rolling Stone, he did not confirm he was gay till another interview with the same magazine in 1988. At that time, he said, coming out gave me the freedom to be who I was for the rest of my life. I don't have to hide around corners. The worst thing is to be afraid of who you are, it's horrible. Known for cult sci-fi hits such as The Matrix series and Cloud Atlas, Lana L. and Lily both came out as transgender in 2008 and 2016, respectively. Lana informed her family while shooting the second and third installments of The Matrix. Lily did so in a statement to Windy City News, after being approached by a Daily Mail reporter. To the latter, she said, Yeah, I'm transgender. And yeah, I've transitioned. The Westworld star revealed her bisexuality in a 2011 interview with Esquire magazine. In 2017, speaking at a human rights campaign gala, she said, a light bulb went off when she first heard the word bisexual. The word didn't make me feel marginalized. It made me feel less crazy. It made me feel less alone. It gave me hope. The Green Day frontman spoke openly about his sexuality in a 1995 interview with The Advocate and said, I think I have always been bisexual. I think people are born bisexual, and it's just that our parents and society kind of veer us off into this feeling of, oh, I can't, they say it's taboo. It's ingrained in our heads that it's bad when it's not bad at all. It's a very beautiful thing. The How I Met Your Mother actor came out in November 2006. In an exclusive interview to People magazine, he said, "I am happy to dispel any rumors or misconceptions and am quite proud to say that I am a very content gay man living my life to the fullest and feel most fortunate to be working with wonderful people in the business I love." Purser, known for her role as Barbara Holland in Stranger Things, came out as bisexual on Twitter in April 2017. Her post read, "I don't normally do this, but I figure now is as good a time as any to get personal. I've only just recently come out as bisexual to my friends and family. It's something I am still processing and trying to understand, and I don't like talking about it too much." The pop star revealed he was gay in April 2017 to People magazine. He stated, "I'm so private. I always have been. I thought I would be disappointing them, his fans, if they knew I was gay. So I never did anything." Born Andrej Pejic, the Bosnian-born Australian model went through sex reassignment surgery to transition from man to woman. In a 2014 Vogue interview, she, now Andrea, said, "I figured out who I was very early on, actually, at the age of 13, with the help of the internet, so I knew that a transition, becoming a woman, was always something I needed to do." 3 years later, she became the first openly transgender model to be signed to the internationally renowned agency, Ford Models. The Orange is the New Black star has a lot of firsts to her name. In 2014, she was the first transgender person to be nominated for a Primetime Emmy. Later that year, she also became the first openly transgender person on the cover of Time magazine. In the accompanying interview, she said, "My third grade teacher called my mom and said, 'Your son is going to end up in New Orleans wearing a dress.' Up until that point, I just thought that I was a girl and that there was no difference between girls and boys. I think in my imagination I thought that I would hit puberty and I would start turning into a girl." The Prison Break actor came out in August 2013 when he posted a letter on GANAMP, Lesbian Alliance Against Defamation's GLAAD website, declining an invitation to attend the St. Petersburg International Film Festival. He wrote, "As a gay man, I must decline. I am deeply troubled by the current attitude toward and treatment of gay men and women by the Russian government. The situation is in no way acceptable, and I cannot in good conscience participate in a celebratory occasion hosted by a country where people like myself are being systematically denied their basic right to live and love openly." The comedian, actress and TV personality acknowledged being gay in February 2002, during a benefit for ovarian cancer research. She stated, "I don't know why people make such a big deal about the gay thing. People are confused, they're shocked, like this is a big revelation to somebody." The child of singers Sonny and Cher, Bono opted for a female-to-male sex reassignment surgery in 2008. In 2011, he wrote about his experiences in a New York Times bestseller, Transition: Becoming Who I Was Always Meant to Be. 5 years later, he said, "I didn't live my life as a girl. I lived my life as a male inside a female body for a long time." The Star Trek actor came out as a gay man in an interview with New York Magazine in October 2011. He said, "Living a gay life without publicly acknowledging it is simply not enough to make any significant contribution to the immense work that lies ahead on the road to complete equality." The Teen Wolf actor appeared to come out after a January 2016 post on Tumblr sparked speculation. A fan commented on Haynes' racy modeling pictures as a secret gay past, to which Haynes replied, "Was it a secret?" A little surprised by all the attention, Haynes made a more formal declaration in an interview with Entertainment Weekly in May that year. He said, "It was a complete shock. I wasn't ready to be back in the headlines. I should have made a comment or a statement, but I just wasn't ready. I didn't feel like I owed anyone anything. I think in due time, everyone has to make those decisions when they're ready, and I wasn't yet. But I felt like I was letting people down by not coming forward with the rest of what I should have said." Woodley, who gained recognition for her role in the TV series The Secret Life of the American Teenager, told The Hollywood Reporter in 2014, "I fall in love with human beings based on who they are, not based on what they do or what sex they are." In 2010, Hayes, who is known for playing Jack McFarland, also gay, in hit sitcom Will & Amp, Grace, spoke to The Advocate about his sexuality. The actor said, "I never have had a problem saying who I am. I am who I am." Ramirez disclosed she was bisexual in a speech at the True Colors Fund's 40 to None Summit in Los Angeles, California, U.S., in 2016. "Because of the intersections that exist in my own life. Woman, multiracial woman, woman of color, queer, bisexual, Mexican-Irish-American, immigrant. I am deeply invested in projects that allow our youth's voices to be heard, and that support our youth in owning their own complex narratives." The Good Wife star identifies himself as bisexual and, in an interview, said, "I'm sexually attracted to the female form even though I am with a man, and I just feel that bisexuals have a bad rap." He is married to Grant Schaefer. Stenberg, known for her role in The Hunger Games, revealed she was bisexual in a 2016 Snapchat appearance for Teen Vogue. But in 2018, she revealed to Wonderland magazine that she is gay. She said, "I was so overcome with this profound sense of relief when I realized that I'm gay, not bi, not pan, but gay, with a romantic love for women." Plaza came out as bisexual in a 2016 interview to The Advocate and said, "I know I have an androgynous thing going on, and there's something masculine about my energy. Girls are into me, that's no secret. Hey, I'm into them too. I fall in love with girls and guys." The American record producer acknowledged his bisexuality in his memoir, The Soundtrack of My Life. Davis, who has been married and divorced twice, came out on The Katie Couric Show, Katie, in 2013. "I'm still attracted to women. You don't have to be only one thing or another. For me, it's the person. I'm in a monogamous relationship, and I respect monogamy. And I hope that this is understood." The Matilda actress disclosed her bisexuality in a series of tweets in 2016. Her revelation came after the tragic massacre at a gay club in Orlando. In an interview to a civil rights organization, the actress said, "One of the reasons I didn't come out for a very long time was because I grew up hearing that bisexual girls were crazy. I heard that all the time. I heard that bisexual girls were crazy, they were greedy, they were selfish and they caused drama. They were the worst. They wanted attention." The Glee alum chose an Ariana Grande song to express his sexuality in April 2018. Hashtag no tears left to cry is gayer than me and I accept. Tie it Ariana Grande tweeted. The 13 Reasons Why actor, who was in a relationship with English singer-songwriter Sam Smith, came out in an emotional Instagram post on September 17, 2017. The two, however, broke up in 2018, after 9 months of dating. In 2012, the white-collar actor publicly thanked his partner Simon Halls and their 3 children via surrogacy while accepting the Steve Chase Humanitarian Award. Bomer stated, "I'd really especially like to thank my beautiful family, Simon, Kit, Walker, Henry. Thank you for teaching me what unconditional love is. You will always be my proudest accomplishment." The Queen plus Adam Lambert frontman confirmed he was gay in an interview with Rolling Stone in June 2009. He said, "I don't think it should be a surprise for anyone to hear I'm gay. I'm proud of my sexuality." The Good Morning America co-host acknowledged her sexual orientation in a Facebook post in December 2013. She wrote, "At this moment I am at peace and filled with joy and gratitude. I am grateful to God, my doctors and nurses for my restored good health. I am grateful for my entire family, my longtime girlfriend, Amber and friends as we prepare to celebrate a glorious New Year together." The singer-songwriter chose the Triangle Ball in January 1993 to announce her sexuality. She said, I think one of the many fears people have about homosexuality is around the children. I think that the more gay parents raise good, strong, compassionate people, the better the world will be. The Canadian actor first spoke about his orientation in 2012 during an interview with Canadian magazine FYI. When asked about his proudest achievement, he replied, my relationships with my family and my friends. My companion Rainer Andreessen and I have been together almost 13 years in Greenwich Village. We both love New York. He further confirmed it in 2013, stating, I don't really talk about it, but everybody knows. He married Andreessen in 2015. The Star Trek actor came out in October 2005 during an interview with Frontiers magazine. He revealed, it's not really coming out, which suggests opening a door and stepping through. It's more like a long, long walk through what began as a narrow corridor that starts to widen. The NSYNC singer came out in July 2006 in a cover story for People magazine. Bass stated, the thing is, I'm not ashamed, that's the one thing I want to say. I don't think it's wrong, I'm not devastated going through this. I'm more liberated and happy than I've been my whole life. I'm just happy. The writer, actress and comedian came out during a same-sex marriage rally in Las Vegas, Nevada, U.S., in November 2008. She said, I don't really talk about my sexual orientation. I didn't feel like I had to. I was just living my life, not necessarily in the closet, but I was living my life. Everybody that knows me personally, they know I'm gay. But that's the way people should be able to live their lives. I'm proud to be a woman. I'm proud to be a black woman, and I'm proud to be gay. In July 2017, the Heroes actor revealed he was gay and married actor Jesse Haddock in April. He wrote on Twitter, my sexual orientation once again came into question this week when a prominent gay man used an awards acceptance speech to out me. While he did not mention me by name, the explicit details of his reference made it easy for the public and media to connect the dots. While it is an odd situation, I thank him because it presents a prime opportunity for me to publicly say that I am indeed a man who proudly loves other men. In fact, this April, I married my husband and I could not be happier. The Canadian pop and country singer announced that she was a gay person in The Advocate in June 1992. She stated, I grew up feeling like there was no one else, no one that I could relate to. If my coming out of the closet makes my fans rethink their ideas about gay people, then I've done something good. The Roseanne actress confirmed she was a lesbian in July 2010, before the launch of her show, The Talk. She stated, I don't think it will be a problem. I don't ever really think of things as out or in. I just think I am who I am, and when topics come up that are appropriate, I'll talk about them and share when it seems right. Wright, one of the first country music artists to come out as gay, acknowledged her orientation in May 2010 to People magazine. She remarked, nothing in my life has been more magical than the moment I decided to come out. The New Kids on the Block member posted on the band's website in January 2011, I have lived my life very openly and have never hidden the fact that I am gay. Prior to his confirming his sexual orientation, he was outed by pop singer Tiffany, who briefly dated him. The Family Ties actress came out during an interview with Matt Lauer on the Today Show in 2009. She disclosed, I am a lesbian and it was a later in life recognition. Some people would say, well, you're living a life and, you know, the truth is, not at all. This has only been for the past 7 years. The country singer came out in November 2014 during an interview with People magazine. He stated, I realized I had an incredible story that could possibly help someone's son or daughter or grandchild's life not be as difficult as mine has been. Maybe they wouldn't have to go through as much pain and suffering. It's time to tell my truth. Nairn, who played Hodor in the HBO series Game of Thrones, revealed in an interview on a fan site in March 2014, when you talk about the gay community, you are talking about my community. I am aware of it, yeah, and I think it's really lovely. Again, it's a privilege, and I really mean that. He also added that his sexuality is a very small part of who I am on the whole, but nonetheless, in this day and age, it's important to stand up and be counted. The actor, who played a closeted gay man in the crime drama series The Playboy Club, came out in real life during an interview with Entertainment Weekly in 2011. He said, "I was nervous coming here today because I've just never talked about it. But it's so liberating. It was interesting to be coming to have a conversation that I was always afraid of. This is my coming out ball. I've been dying to do this." He has been through a legal appeals process, which has dragged on for several years. His initial claim for asylum was rejected in October 2016, so too was an appeal against the decision in December that year. After being granted permission to appeal to the upper tier, it was dismissed in August 2017. He was twice refused the right to appeal to the Court of Appeal in October 2017 and June 2018. Further submissions were refused in September and October 2018. Macharia, from Glastonbury, lodged new submissions in November and December, which were the subject of the Home Office's Latest decision. A judge previously accepted that Macharia is gay but dismissed his claim that he would suffer persecution in Kenya. In its latest letter, the Home Office rejected Macharia's concerns that he would be targeted because he was a high-profile homosexual man, based on a string of news stories in the Kenyan press about his case, some of which prompted homophobic comments. Facebook comments seen by The Guardian underneath a Kenyan news article about Macharia in November describe him as a very bad example to the society in Kenya. Another states, "We don't need more demons here." The Home Office letter said, "No evidence has been submitted to show that you will be singled out and persecuted by the authorities in Kenya as a result of your case being reported in the media." The letter noted that homophobic comments were very distasteful, but there were no direct threats to Macharia. In its decision, the Home Office also cited its own March 2017 document on sexual orientation and gender identity in Kenya, which noted that although same-sex sexual activity between men is criminalized with a penalty of up to 21 years in prison, it is not clear if there have been any convictions. It added, "Sources suggest that the law on unnatural offenses is rarely applied, and there have only been two recent reported cases of its use, one of which was dismissed and the other still ongoing at the time of publication." The Home Office document conceded that the police have arrested some LGBT persons but added, "This is usually followed by their release shortly afterwards." The document also acknowledged the police have also reportedly harassed LGBT persons, or those believed to be so, and have subjected some to blackmail and rape. Public order laws have been used by the police as a means to arrest LGBT persons, especially those working in the sex industry. But it added, "There have, however, also been some occasions where the police have protected LGBT persons against mob attack." The document further states, "In general, the evidence available does not establish that LGBT persons are likely to be subject to persecution or serious harm by the state." The Home Office's decision letter concluded, "Taking the above objective evidence into full consideration alongside the reports enclosed, there is no evidence to support your claim that homosexuals, sick, in Kenya suffer persecution by either the state or non-state actors." It continued, "It is also noted from the above objective evidence that effective state protection is likely to be available, which you could access should you fear reprisals from mob justice or other people." The document added that there is nothing to show that you would be persecuted by the state as a result of your sexual orientation as a homosexual. On Monday, a Home Office spokesman said, "This government has a proud record of providing protection for asylum seekers fleeing persecution because of their sexual orientation or gender identity. All available evidence is carefully and sensitively considered in light of published country information. All decisions on claims based on sexual orientation are subject to an additional safeguard reviewed by a second experienced caseworker. Macharia said he would consult his lawyer about his next steps.